boys and girls, happy St. Patrick's Day. Who knows, without Googling, who was St. Patrick and what was St. Patrick? No cheating. Today we're going to make a, look, I got a green beer koozie for St. Patrick's Day. We're going to do traditional corned beef and cabbage. I'm going to do it all in one pot, because it's easier, number one. And you can do it in the oven, and it's more flavorful like that. But you got to soak it in a bowl of water and change the water a couple times over a 24-hour period, or at least overnight while you sleep, and get up and keep changing the water. To leach some of the salt out of it. Otherwise it'll be too salty if you do it in the oven, but it does come out a lot better in the oven. And you could actually smoke it also, just like that, or smoke it with pastrami rub on the outside of it. And I've done that before. Google my channel. Let's have a little lesson, a little quick lesson, something I was reading about. Let me read to you the theory first that I had to take some notes on here. And I actually experimented with this one time. You know, I cook steaks all the time, grill them. I'll skillet fry them, or skillet, you know, crusted them. And they lose more liquid when you're doing grilling or skillet crusted. I took a T-bone a good while back and deep fried it, and it retained more liquids and was juicier in the end, and it didn't get oily. Oil and water don't mix. Let me explain that to you. Let me show you here. I'll draw a little picture. Oh, pot, meat. The meat got water in it, but the water tries to go out and it's forced back in from the oil. It forces itself back into the meat, so it retains more liquid. Oil and water don't mix. Same way with the oil. It won't go into the meat. It's repelled away from the liquid in the meat. There, I think I drew that properly. Why is that? Let's see here what it say. Oil has roughly half the thermal capacity of water, which means it requires half the amount of energy to reach the same temperature as an equal volume of water. This in turn means it has less energy to transfer to the food and will cook it more slowly. Okay? This is the same type of principle as in fried chicken. You'll notice the chicken's not oily inside. Now, you can get the crust too oily on fried chicken if you screw up and don't have the oil at the right temperature when you start, or let the oil cook down from overloading your pan. Same way with fried fish. If you don't believe that concept is true, heat a pot of water to exactly 135 degrees. And heat another pot of water to heat the second pot of oil to 135 degrees. Exactly, with a thermometer that's accurate. Stick your finger in the 135 degree water. You're gonna pull it right out, it's gonna be hot. And it'll burn you if you not stupid. Stick your finger in a pot of 135 degree oil, it's just gonna feel warm to you. It's physics, nuclear physics. That's your lesson for the week, okay? That's enough of that. But I'm not gonna ball that corned beef in oil, because it's gonna take too much oil. It's a big hunk of meat. But you can poach fish in oil, you can poach eggs in oil, and you can displace the amount of oil that's in your pan or not use as much. You better be recording, you non-union son of a bitch, good. By like putting the onion, cut onion in half, stick it in the pan with some oil, and the onion is going to displace the oil, take up some space in the pan, and you won't need as much oil to poach a fish or an egg or something like that. Now that's low temperature. We ain't talking about deep frying fish. I'm talking about poaching like at 135 degrees, 140 degrees. And your fish, say, would retain more moisture. It's going to be juicier. Top restaurants use this technique all the time. That's one reason why if you're poaching in water, your fish is going to be drier. It's going to lose almost twice as much liquid poached in water as it would poached in oil. And it ain't going to be early. Boy, the early bird ain't going to be early. Or should I say flipper ain't going to be early. Yeah. Corned beef. This is the flat. They sell a flat end point of the corned beef. Which is really, this is part of a brisket. This is the flat part of the brisket. And here's going back to the point, which is, brisket looks like a foot. It's missing the toes. Somebody cut the toes off. Oh, oh. And this little piggy went to the market. Oh, this is beef, this ain't pig. Let's open this dog up. GB, you could have got a sharp knife instead of this girl, son of a bitch. Don't rinse none of this juice off of here either. You want to cook with this liquid that's in there, which is part of the brine and part of the corned beef. So don't rinse it off. Pour it in there. That's flavor. Put your beast in the water. You bring it to a boil. Get your flavor package. Did you see over there? I hope so. Got it. Look, it's in the pot. With some of the juice come out the bag. Get your flavor packet with peppercorns, mustard seed, coriander, bust up bay leaves. You can even add more if you want to. Put no salt in there though. If you do, you're going to be stupid and pissed off. Because it's going to be most likely too salty. So open up your little package of seeds. Yeah, it didn't say tear here. Just whack here. Pour them in there. If you want to add some more, do it. Oh, there's clove in there also. And that's basically the same stuff you would grind all that up. Basically the same stuff you would put in on the outside of a pastrami. All ground up. Just more of it. I'm going to add a couple. No, I'm going to just leave it like that, just burning until it's ready. It says on the package, so many minutes a pound. So read that before you throw the package away. I'm going to also put some corn, potatoes, carrots. I know. Almost forgot. I'm going to go ahead and put some apples in there too. A buddy of mine told me about using some half water and half apple juice in this boiling liquid. Miss JB bought these apples for something and they're too tart. But she don't know this, what how many different varieties of apples. These are Galas. They're too tart for what she wanted to do. So I'm gonna wash them and put a couple in there and it's gonna give it a apple flavor. Hey, sweet, I was eating one the other day, but I don't know what she was wanting to make with them. They're good. So, wash them, whack them up, chunk them in there. See? Put them in there. Don't worry about the seeds. They ain't gonna grow no apple tree. Nah, go burn them. Well, put the other shit in there now because this gotta cook for, I'm sure, about 2-3 hours. Depending on the weight of that beast. Put the lid on the pot. So the heat don't come out. It'll boil faster and use less fuel. Oh no, huh? Amazing. Now we got some Big Easy sausage. We're gonna chunk in there. It's been going for a couple hours. And the sausage is gonna give this a nice smoky flavor to that corned beef. I hate to burrow sausage, but we're gonna sacrifice it. Some apples and the corned beef. Just put it in there, JB. Don't worry about it. Looking good in that pot right now. Look back in there. Bring it back to the barrel. We ain't ready for the vegetables yet. We're gonna let that sausage go for just... Okay, well, we got 2 hours. We let the sausage go for another good 45 minutes to an hour. Then we'll chunk the other shit in there. All right, boy. I'm gonna watch a movie. We're gonna go ahead and put some garlic, a whole head, and a whole onion in there. And you eat that. You don't play around and be stupid. You eat that. I may throw a whole lemon in there too. Yeah, if you put that in too soon, it's gonna cook too much. So we just put it in after, right after the sausage. And it's gonna give more flavor to everything from here on out. What's up, Doc? Peel some damn carrots and put it in the roast. What you think I am, Bugs Bunny? Okay, I'm gonna put in potatoes and carrots and all that other shit. So, here's some cabbage. Cabbage fruit. Let's go ahead and put in about half a head of this. Quarter it up. Can you make cabbage rolls with that other stuff? Yeah. Sure can. Quarter this and steam it some. Right? Like that. Simple, huh? Chunk it in the pot. Okie dokie. Now I went ahead and did this cabbage in a separate pot just for the hell of it. And I poured a lot of vinegar and vine gar in there. And look down here. There's some garlic. And here's your onion. See how it squeezes out of there like that? Oh man, that's some fine stuff. That's what you want to eat. Put all that up on there. Like that. You'll be able to squeeze that onion out. Two. You got some carrots and taters and corned beef. Here's the rest of the corned beef. Watch it slice with this. See like that? How it falling all apart. Put that on the plate too. Get you some good German mustard or horseradish and eat. Yum. Bald dinner. Very good, very good, healthy for you. And eat. And I got some of this Balsnar stoofs. So put you some of that with the juice. Come on there, boy. On that corned beef. Get you some butter for all your other stuff. What else you want to know? It's easy. What's up, Doc?